This is a production of WKNO Memphis. Production funding for this program is made possible in part by the WKNO Production Fund, the WKNO Endowment Fund, and by viewers like you. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mamie Shannon. Welcome to Local Color. I'm so excited. We have Dale Skaggs here, who's the director of horticulture from Dixon Gallery and Gardens. Thank you for joining us finally.
I'm happy to be here.
We talk about events and things that are going on all the time at Dixon. Tell me something that if I go to the Dixon, I'm not going to really expect.
Well, this summer, our annual color beds, many of you are familiar with our stunning seasonal color displays where we bed out annual color, and we change those displays out about three times a year. And this summer, we're going to replace a lot of those flowers with what we're calling edible ornamentals, which are plants that you can consume, but they have ornamental value as well.
It's not like a salad bar where we can just come to the Dixon and enjoy the edible buffet. It's there to view, right?
Yes, it's to view and to educate about edible ornamentals. It's really a trend in public gardens and just a trend across the nation, you know, eating local and eating foods that
Absolutely.
Are local and things like that.
I know that you rotate the plants out all the time, so is this going to be an ongoing thing where now you've got spring plants, when summer comes, the summers will be in bloom, and then in fall we'll have fall edibles as well?
Well, this is will be all planted by June 1st, and it will run through probably August. It's you know, nature's kind of humbling, so we don't know exactly how long it will last.
Especially this year, since everything bloomed in a one-week period.
Yeah, so early.
Well, thank you so much for that. I'm going to have to check that out. Yeah. Mark, I'm glad you're here, too.
Well, thanks for having me.
And tell me about my favorite band is coming to town. They're playing at Mud Island.
I'm assuming you mean Wilco,
Wilco.
Band, which is like purling hiss.
Now, wait a minute.
Fan. What do you mean?
Don't be dissing the hiss.
Is that the original purling hiss, or is that a new one?
I think it's it's a tribute purling hiss, I believe, yes.
Don't be dissing the hiss.
Wilco's coming back to Mud Island again. Did you know this is, by the way, the 30th anniversary of the opening of Mud Island? 2012 is?
And you know what? Have you guys been there
opened
lately?
1982.
Have you guys been there lately? I totally forgot how cool
The river walk is.
Yeah.
No, the river.
It is really an architectural gem, and it's free.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's my favorite thing. So before you go to Wilco, and when is Wilco playing?
Wilco is playing on Saturday.
The 19th, and the concert starts at 8.
8.
And will the hiss start?
Purling hiss, I imagine, will start about 8 o'clock.
Okay, super, super. And you can get tickets online still?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Now, Pat, Rock-N-Romp, isn't there a Rock-N-Romp this weekend?
Yes. Rock-N-Romp this weekend is at Rhodes. It is, for anyone who has not been to Rock-N-Romp, if you have kids, it is the perfect experience where, as parents, you can just let your kids go. It's a controlled environment. The kids are playing with each other, listening to music, doing crafts. They stay busy and they have a great time. It's, you know, when they started Rock-N-Romp, the whole idea behind it was, you know, a bunch of parents who couldn't go to see live shows as often because they have a family now. So how can we create an environment where the whole family can come and experience live music? So they have been, for the last few years, they've transitioned from doing events at homes, at people's homes. It just got too big and they couldn't.
It blew up.
Yeah, the backyards were just, you know, overflowing. To now they find public places. So they've done the Metal Museum, they've done the Center for Southern Folklore, and this one is at Rhodes. So it's going to be fun.
Who's playing?
I completely forgot.
Okay,
the name
I've got
of the
it.
Band.
I've got it. No. Kaleidophonic? Is that
Kaleidophonics.
Right?
And it is so like
Lion Science.
Here's my one thing about Rock-N-Romp. I never look at who's playing because it's one of those things where the music's going to be great. Alicia Trout helps program the music from River City Tanline.
And she's done a fantastic job.
And you just know it's going to be good. It's sort of like those concert series where you don't even, you don't wait to get your ticket. You just get your ticket, and then you're like, I know I'm going to see great music.
Okay, so it's Kaleidophonics.
Yes, exactly.
It's Kaleidophonics, Lion Science, and Thunder Punch, and it's this Saturday from 2 to 5 at Rhodes College. Here's the big, big, big thing you need to remember. If you don't have a kid, you don't get in.
Go.
You have to have a child to get in.
So and steal I love a child. That.
Preferably do not steal a child. Okay. You can borrow one. Okay. But you have to have a child to get in.
Okay. And there,
or go
there
with
are
somebody
people,
that has two.
There, you know, that's a really good point, though. I know a number of people that go that don't have kids, but they have god kids.
Yes.
Or they're, you know, they're the aunt and uncle, and it's their quality time.
Or look, the
that
mama,
they get.
Look,
I'm going to be cool and take, you know, take little Joey to see some music.
I've got something to do this weekend. Pat, will you take Hannah with you guys?
Right.
Absolutely.
It's perfect.
It's a win-win. Chris,
mm-hmm.
Tennessee Shakespeare Company is presenting the Glass Menagerie at the Dixon.
They are, as part of their Southern Exposure series, and I think it's nice that now, you know, both parts of the name are being represented in what they do.
Yes.
You know, a little bit of Shakespeare, a little bit of Tennessee Williams.
Yes.
And, you know, it's going to be interesting to see this very intimate play in an outdoor environment. They've got a fantastic cast that include a couple of really great locals. Christina Welford Scott is going to be playing Amanda Wingfield, one of dramatic literature's, you know, most famous mother figures. Darius Wallace, who's been doing work with the Tennessee Shakespeare Festival for quite a while, is going to really get to step up and be showcased as Jim, the gentleman caller. And, you know, it's this fantastic play that everybody knows or thinks they know because you grow up with it, and lots of high schools do it, to the point that I think we forget sometimes how great a play it really is. And it was set, you know, Tom in his opening monologue talks about how the world is falling apart and everyone is angry because there's, you know, economic crisis here and economic crisis there. And in America, the, you know, our fingers are being forcibly pressed down on the fiery Braille alphabet of a dissolving economy. And it looks, it contrasts this glass menagerie that's being built by Laura, this very shy cripple girl, with the harsh realities of life in the St. Louis tenements in a broken family. I mean, it's, you know, it's always for better and worse, always more current than you probably think it is.
Mm-hmm. And what a beautiful play and what a beautiful setting, too. Mm-hmm. I'm really excited about that one.
Great people, great material. It's his first breakthrough play. I think some would still argue it may even be his, you know, his tightest and best piece.
It runs May the 23rd through June the 3rd.
Mm-hmm.
But you can go to our website, wkno.org/localcolor. And we will have a link to everything that we're talking about today, so don't feel like you've got to take notes on everything. But speaking about a beautiful setting, have you guys been out to Millington to the Glen Eagle Golf Course? It's gorgeous. They just built a new clubhouse. They've redone the grounds. And what they're doing is, for the month of May, every Friday, they're having free concerts on the green. May the 18th is going to be Andy Childs. You guys remember Andy?
Oh, yes.
Andy's a Memphian who has moved away to Nashville, but he's coming back.
He comes back a lot. It feels like Andy lives here because he does come back a couple times a year.
I-40 is only 45 minutes for Andy. May the 18th is Andy Childs at 6:30. And then next Friday,
the 25th
is the Almost Famous Band.
Yes, and I do believe our friend Scott Sudbury is still in that band. Scott is one of my favorite artists in town.
And he's such a good guy.
He's just a wonderful fella. He's a really good songwriter, and he always gives you a great show.
He's really there for the audience.
He really wants to make sure you have a good time.
Well, this is one thing that's cool. There's food available there, food and beverages. You can bring your own picnic basket, bring your own lawn chair, bring your own little blanket, have a concert on the green. And another thing, you guys, I love Cajun food, and I'm always looking for some good Cajun food around here. Millington, the Cajun Kitchen. They have alligator. They have...
Alligator?
It's wonderful. They've got the bread from New Orleans, the bakery that starts with a D. I can't remember it.
I'm not sure which one.
I'll think about it at 3 o'clock in the morning, but it's the bread that has the poor boys that I love.
Mm-hmm.
They've got good Cajun food. It's great prices. It's called the Cajun Kitchen. It's on 8412 Highway 51 North. right across from Walmart in Millington. Can't miss it. Local mom and pop. She's a native from New Orleans, so, you know, she's upholding her tradition and standard. So you guys go give Cajun Kitchen a shout. And I had a peacemaker last week. It was fantastic, and I'm going back probably tomorrow for an alligator po' boy.
So what does alligator taste like, chicken?
It's yeah, it tastes like chicken.
You know, weirdly enough, I would say it's like in that frog legs category.
Yeah.
Where it's somewhere between chicken and fish.
It's
like the chicken fish.
It's a consistency of chicken, kind of, but then it's kind of got that little fish flair, and
tough.
I love
it. You want to get younger alligators because the bigger ones actually taste muddy. I have Louisiana people, and the
he
twins.
He knows some folks.
I always stay away from old alligators.
You can get the alligator tail from the Paradise Seafood truck at the farmer's market every week. So the twins, every week, they want alligator chili for Sunday brunch.
Well, and they also have alligator gumbo at Cajun Kitchen, too. So it's not just the fried alligator tails or anything like that. They've got the appetizers,
that might be
the poor boys.
A good place to start, huh?
Yeah, it's really good.
It
I kept
really
thinking,
good.
why do we grow all these chickens when we could just grow this gator that tastes really good?
If you ever get one, if you ever get one that's
back.
Too old, you will understand why some people are just like no. Yeah.
So Dale, this is pretty exciting. Memphis has never had a rose show before?
No, for 50 some odd years they've had a rose show. They've never had it at the Dixon. So.
At the Dixon?
Yeah, so.
Well, that's cool. Tell me about it.
Well, this weekend is the rose show. There'll be the Memphis Dixie Rose Club is offering a rose show, and a lot of it's cut stems and flower arrangements. I don't know how many of you are familiar with a flower show, but it's basically cut stems in a vase, and anyone can enter. You don't have to be a member to enter.
Okay, so I grow roses. I've got a beauty. I can cut it, put it in a vase, bring it, enter it.
And there'll be volunteers there to help you with grooming and entering it. And if you don't know, preferably you know the name on it, but if you don't know the name, there's categories for that you can enter as well. We're encouraging children to enter roses. And of course, the rosarians in town, there's quite a few, and they'll be bringing lots of roses as well. So
when can we, the public, come and see the winners?
Well, the judging is at 11:30, and I think it's open to the public from 2 to 5.
Okay.
So
that's Saturday and Sunday.
Well, Sunday, I think the winners are going to be on display.
And gotcha. Yeah. Okay, so Saturday, everything will be on display, and then Sunday, they'll be on display, but we'll know who the winners are.
Yes. You know, everybody loves roses. You know?
Oh, heck yeah.
It would really be interesting to go both days though, because I don't know what is a winner look like. I mean, they're all beautiful to me.
So
I can't tell the difference, so it would be nice to see these were the ones that were selected as the best.
You know what, maybe next year you should have a People's Choice Award.
Ooh,
how about that?
That
a blind People's Choice Award, that would be fun.
But these flowers you cannot eat, right?
You cannot eat. No,
okay. These are not edible. Yeah.
I just want to make sure I got this all clear in my head.
Okay, the Levitt Shell has just announced their free concert series.
Well, they announced it a while back, but it's getting ready to kick off. Kicks off on Thursday, and then with the Stooges Brass Band. It's 7 weeks of free concerts. That's not every day. It's Thursday, Friday, Saturdays, and Sundays.
Yeah, but it may as well be Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's really one of the best music deals in town. It's all free.
No, it starts at 7:30, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then Sunday it's six.
And they used to have a children's show on Saturday afternoons before the regular show, but now they've given children their own day, Sunday. So Sunday is all family day.
Oh, that's cool.
So it's like Rock-N-Romp every week. Sorry, I didn't mean to show you up there.
Yeah, thanks.
Every week. And, oh, that's cool.
Saturday night, I'm really excited about the show on Saturday
night.
It's
going to be cool.
It's The Wandering, which is Luther Dickinson and
Levitt
Shell.
Yeah, and
Valerie
June. Oh,
I love
Shanae her. Yeah, and Sade is the granddaughter of Otha Turner. So she's in the band Shannon McNally. I mean,
we're talking about, this is royalty.
It's so cool. I've gone online to listen to it because I was like, what? I love the pictures, so I thought, I wonder what this is going to sound like. And it's all traditional music. It's just so, like, it looks good. It sounds good. It should just be huge.
And it's free.
They've been on the road together, so they're going to come back with a little road muscle.
And if you haven't seen Overton Park in a little while, the Overton Park Conservancy has taken over management of the park, and they're just doing a great job.
They really
are. Really cleaning the place up a lot. They're opening up a dog park pretty soon.
Actually, Saturday morning, little known fact, Saturday morning, my daughter's volunteer group, her kids' volunteer group, is going to clean Overton Park. And so they're spending Saturday morning cleaning Overton Park, and this is something that Clean Memphis and the Conservancy set up. You know,
I can't even get the twins to clean their room.
I know.
Well, they'll do it. If you get them in a group and it's an outing and they get snacks and all that, it's a lot easier.
Oh, I can give snacks all day. Good night.
Well, that's a real gem in the city, though, to have old growth forest
in
the center of Memphis, in the heart of Memphis. That's pretty amazing.
Absolutely. I wish I knew of a horticulturist who could help me, but I tell you what I'm looking for. I'm looking for an oak leaf hydrangea. Yeah. Which, well, they're native to Tennessee, right?
Yes, they are native to Tennessee, and they're in full flower right
they're
now.
They're gorgeous.
The Dixon, yeah.
They're absolutely
year,
gorgeous.
Yeah.
Karen Brown's coming to the Boom Boom room.
The Rumba room. You're going to Miami.
Well, no. The Boom Boom room is actually over on Thomas. Have you not seen the Boom Boom room?
Oh yeah. I've passed by it actually.
That's where I want to have Hannah's birthday party.
Let's go there after this.
There, Karen Brown, amazing neo-soul artist here in town. I hate saying neo-soul because it's really not new anymore. But soul artist, she's just one of those voices that just, that's all I can say. You just watch her and you're just like, wow. You know, you feel like, why am I so lucky to hear this woman here in Memphis? She should be, you know, performing all over the world. She's just absolutely amazing. She does, she is also in, does gospel music, but her soul show, she performs out maybe, you know, a couple times a year. She does a show, and this is her birthday party. So it's going to be a fabulous, you know, fabulous event. And I think that it's going to be packed. It's going to be fun. And she's one of the few people that can get in the Rumba Room and really feel the room. It's, you know, sound sometimes gets lost in the ceiling in the room. And so she gets in there and somehow her voice just takes over. And you just feel like, woo, she's talking to my soul. That's what the experience is like.
And if you've never been to the Rumba Room, go early because their food is delicious. The
yes.
drinks are so unique and refreshing. It's a Cuban flair. It's a neat room. I really like it.
And they've also got, you know, they'll have dancing there. If they've got a great dance floor, it's just really, it's a really refreshing room to go to.
And they're making a real concentrated effort to step up the live music that they bring.
And it's Sunday, May the 20th. I don't know the time. Do you?
It is. I think it starts at 6:30.
Okay. So definitely go to wkno.org/localcolor. Go to the website and check it out for the time. But yeah, that sounds like a cool show. That sounds like a great Sunday afternoon.
Mm-hmm. It's not too late.
Okay. You know, have you noticed the little theme that we've got going on? Dale comes on the show and where everything is bloom and landscape and...
You want to know about Project Motion.
You got it.
Project Motion, Memphis's, you know, premier modern dance company, are 25 years old this year. And this is the end of their 25th season. And they are celebrating that with a concert that is, all season long, they've had themes to their shows. And the last concert always really showcases their choreographers. And everything that they're doing is going to be inspired by blooming, by blossoming, by greenscaping. And so there are going to be dances that are inspired by the changing seasons along the green line. There's one visiting performer, Peter Carpenter, he's been here before, who has a tendency to be very political with his work. And so he's taking green in a completely different direction. And I understand it's going to be a performance that involves some significant amount of money that they are in people's mouths and people's hands. I don't know. It's supposed to be a piece about consumerism. So there's going to be dances inspired by one called Playing Through, choreographed by Louisa Keppel. It's sort of inspired by, like, you know, playing through a park like golf or polo. It's going to have a competitive spirit. So that's it.
Well, that sounds cool.
They are continuing. After 25 years, they are continuing to blossom.
And so this is going to be Friday, May the 18th, mm-hmm. Through Sunday, May the 27th.
Yes.
Is that correct?
I think that's right.
And it's going to be at Evergreen Theater.
At Evergreen Theater, the old, not the current Circuit Playhouse that was on Poplar. It's still confusing to some people. The Evergreen Theater.
I went last week.
I think it was a movie theater.
It's had a few names. It was at one point the Evergreen Theater. Yes.
I went last week to see Veronica's Room there, and I fell in love with that little place. It is so pretty.
Very intimate.
It's so pretty.
You feel like you're in the show. It's right there, and you're watching it.
And it doesn't look on the outside like the interior does. I loved it. I thought it was really cute.
Very happy when Playhouse on the Square built its new facility and, you know, it expanded the theatrical possibilities in Memphis. But part of me was just heartbroken because that going to see things at that Circuit Playhouse that was part of the programmed Playhouse season was something I always looked forward to.
Well, I thoroughly enjoyed it. I loved the venue. I thought it was really cool. Cottages for a Cure is going on through May the 19th. Architects and builders have gotten together to create children's playhouses, and they're actually on site at the Avenue at Carriage Crossing in Collierville, where you can just go and look at them. You can vote. It's kind of like, you know, the Vesta Home Show. This is the kids' home show.
Yeah.
You can go and look at these cottages and vote on the one that you like the best. And then Friday, May the 19th at 7, they're going to sell them. So you can actually go Friday, May the 19th. It's a ticketed event. It's free to go and just see the cottages and look at them. But then on May the 19th, it's a ticketed event. You can go and buy these cottages, and they're really cute.
That's nice.
One thing that's cool is on Friday night, they're also having free Friday night movies. I think they call it Movies on the Green at Carriage Crossing, and this week is Spy Kids. So,
one of my personal favorites.
Spy Kids 2 or 3 or 7 or whichever one was the latest. I don't know which
three.
One.
3.
3. I think it's the latest.
Which is the best?
Which is the best?
Yeah.
It was a lot better, but the first one, I just adored the first one.
I did too.
It was just...
I did too.
I can't even remember if I had a family per se then. I just watched
That's
it
probably
as
the
me.
Inspiration.
Yeah, maybe it was. I've got to get a family. That looks great.
So we can be spies together. Tell me about the Munch and Learn that you've got coming up.
Yeah, next week, Dr. Chris Cooper, who does the family
plot. Our
very
own.
Yeah, he's going to be speaking at the Dixon Munch and Learn. There's a lot of master gardeners in the city. In fact, Memphis area master gardeners is the largest in the state. And he's going to sort of tell you what it is to be a master gardener. And
why don't we ever hear anything about that? All these things about Memphis and there are all these negative things. That's just really interesting in our urban community.
Master gardeners than anybody. We have such
doing
a
great
beautiful.
Things. They all have to give these volunteer hours, and at the Dixon, we couldn't accomplish everything we do in the gardens without them, and we have just. 50 or 60 master gardener volunteers that come on a regular basis,
I'm
and then others.
I'm just
going to
declare this master gardener show. How about that? Thank you guys for everything that you do. So can me a person?
Yeah, it's free
without
paid admission. Members get in free, obviously, but
so
it's
you
free
don't have to be a master gardener to attend.
No. In fact, it's designed to attract folks who might be interested in the master gardener program, learning more about it, what it takes to become a master gardener, sort of thing.
Cool.
So hopefully recruit some new master gardeners to go out and do good things.
Well, I love that. Tell me what's going on. Okay, now that's the 23rd, next
Wednesday. Yeah, the 23rd.
Next Wednesday, the 23rd at noon.
Yes.
Cool. Thank you.
Bring a lunch and enjoy a lunch and listen to Dr. Chris Cooper.
Just don't eat the edible ornamentals.
Well, they won't be ready yet.
Okay.
Maybe we'll serve them at one munch and learn
like
later on.
That's like our joke theme.
For
when in doubt, refer back to the edible
ornamentals.
Yeah, well, that's sort of one of the inspirations.
So we got a lot of country women coming into town.
We do. If you like your singing ladies with a little red around the neck, then then there's a lot of choices for you this weekend.
You see, he looked at me when he said that.
Wasn't pointing fingers.
That was me.
So Miranda Lambert,
who is just one of the biggest stars in country right now, she got a new record out, her fourth record, cleverly called For the Record, F-O-U-R, the record. And she will be at the Lander Center, formerly the DeSoto Civic Center, down in South Haven. It's a big bill. She's got two other singers, Gary Clark and, I'm not sure if I'm saying his name right, Gerard Neiman, will be opening up. And also in the middle of her set, though, Miranda will also bring out two friends of hers in this new trio she has called the Pistol Annies.
Oh, cool.
And they'll do a little subset of Pistol Annie songs.
Okay, now, this one I'm pretty excited about.
Yeah.
Tell us about what's happening in the at the casino.
Gambling, for one thing. But then Pam Tillis and Lori Morgan. They're both Music City royalty. Pam Tillis is obviously Mel Tillis' daughter, and then Lori Morgan is the daughter of George Morgan, who was a big country music hall of famer who passed away in the 70s. But so they're both sort of second-generation country stars, and they're teaming up. They've been playing together for about 2 years now, and now they're actually working on a record together, their first record together.
We're running out of time, but quick, RuPaul's Drag Race.
You know, I love Mexican food. But every time I've ever sat down to a big plate of tacos and refried beans, I've thought something's missing.
It's a drag
and
show.
And it turns out it was a drag show. And thankfully for, you know, if you're like me and like a little drag with your burrito, you can go to Cafe Olay on Friday.
Before the burrito, not after.
It's one Friday a month.
I'm not sure
which Friday, but we'll have that on
Friday
the website.
One Friday a month between now and October, I think. The contestants from RuPaul's Drag Race are coming to Memphis to perform.
And I've got to get this in real quick. The 7th Annual Conference, the Delta Everything Southern at University of Memphis, Rose Theater Lecture Hall, June 8th. It's 8 in the morning till 4:20 in the afternoon. Speakers, images, music relative to the Mississippi Delta. Willie Bearden is speaking. Dolph Smith and photographer Maud Clay. Richard Leatherman, Rudy Scheidt. Go out, enjoy your local color. Thanks, guys. Come back next week.